Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you how you can build the smallest 3x3 double door I ever designed, which is this thing here right in front of you. So as you can see, when I flick this lever, this 3x3 double door closes up in a kind of spiral sequence, which is a bit uncommon. It obviously looks the same from each side. And if I flick the lever again, it also opens up in a spiral sequence. So pretty nice, pretty fast. And very, very compact. The only real downsides to this design are, for one, you will have to use a repeater if you want to relocate the lever. So you need a bit more space to one side. And also there is one visible piston right there, which was needed to get the folded double piston extender working to make this entire thing that compact. You can hide it a bit by using oak planks in the central ring here, for example. But anyway, that's basically what this thing does. Now let's talk about the sizes. As mentioned, this is the smallest size I could make it. And it's 7 blocks wide, 7 blocks high, and 3 blocks long. 5 blocks if you count the front and the back wall. This block up there is just to silence the rather noisy node block there. And not really part of the circuitry. So in total volume, it's 147 blocks only. So very, very compact. And with that, let's talk about the required resources. So if you want to build this, you're gonna need, of course, some building blocks, then 5 redstone dust, a single repeater, 7 observers, 19 sticky pistons, 5 node blocks, and a single lever. So overall, it's pretty cheap, actually. Also, you may want to include some glowstone or similar as a light source to keep mobs from spawning, but besides of that, this is pretty much all you're gonna need. And with that, it's time to finally show you how to build this door here. Okay, so start by marking the center of the floor of the future door with a single block. Then from this one, go 2 blocks up and 3 blocks towards the right, where you place a normal block. Below that, we need a node block, followed by an observer looking at the node block, followed by a normal block. Then, around the corner towards the center, place a node block, observer, normal block, which should end up right below our marking block. Then, another node block, observer, normal block. Then, on top of this one, place a node block, observer, full block. And now, this should be somewhat symmetrical, as you can see here. Then, place redstone dust on top of those two blocks. Now I would also recommend placing a block on top of this one here, or you will get a lot of annoying noise later when the door is working. And next, grab sticky pistons, place them to the front and the back of this central block there. Then we can already fill in the floor. Then on the left and on the right, we can place 3 sticky pistons just like this in each corner. And with that, we can also start filling in the walls. And if you accidentally click on one of those, just click again and everything should even out again. Here, when you're doing this, make sure that on the left side, this block here is a full block, because now we place a sticky piston on top of that one and a sticky piston powering downwards in front of that one. Then an observer on top of this redstone wire here. Make sure this stays in the cross shape. Block on top. Node block on top of the piston. Observer on top of this piston. Then here, first place a full block on top of this redstone wire. Again, make sure this is in the cross shape. Then a repeater in this direction. Some redstone dust on top of here. An observer on top of the repeater looking at the redstone wire. The shape of that one doesn't really matter. Running into a full block. Then diagonal to the front and back of that one. Down, we need full blocks with redstone dust on top. And now all that's left is filling in 3 sticky pistons, as you can see here. And then simply fill in the rest of the ceiling. And that's pretty much everything done. Our input is in this block here, so let's place our lever for now. And you should see everything closing up. And as you can hear, I might suggest place a block on top of this node block. to make it less noisy. And you can see it's now working. The only downside of this design here is if you want to power it remotely, you will need a repeater to run this into this block there. Or this thing here will not work properly. Since you need not only to power the redstone wire up there, but also the redstone wire down there. And with that, the door is pretty much finished. All that's left is filling in the front and the back wall and relocating the lever as already mentioned. And voila, so as you can see, now everything is finished up. I also decided to add a bit of a light source in the center to keep mobs from spawning and tried to hide the piston a bit by using oak planks as this central ring there. But besides of that, this is pretty much how you can build my smallest 3x3 double vault door. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial and well, see ya!